So we're beginning our descent down this not very steeply inclined shaft that I believe goes for, I want to say, 3,000 feet, something like that, maybe more. It's a really long walk, and this takes us down into the mine. And this was a silver mine, and zinc and copper were the minerals that were mined here. So we'll keep going down here and we'll check it all out.
This is why I found this dude here.
Okay, we're coming to some kind of junction here, not too far in from the portal. And there's apparently a bulkhead here, Paul says, to the right. Yep. There's a parallel tunnel here that parallels the one we're in, and it is very wet compared to this one. So they put this bulkhead here to keep the moisture from coming over into this access tunnel. And that's what that is. Yeah, the other tunnel is really...
This is wet air coming out of here.
Yeah.
That's the only opening into there.
Yeah, that other tunnel is very dangerous because of all the... It's totally wet in there, just very misty and damp and...
Cool air, that's weird. That's awesome.
Okay, we're coming down the tunnel here, and there's a major collapse right here that we're going over. See where it fell down from there, probably, right up there. And we'll keep going forward here. And here's a shot looking back up towards the portal. There's a shopping cart here in the mine from HQ Office Supplies Warehouse. You never know what you'll find down in these tunnels. Okay, so we're continuing down the incline here in the Admiral Ward Mine, and here's the first timbered section with steel timbering instead of wood. And then they put the wooden slats on the outside, but the ribs are made out of metal. And you can see it there. This was a weak area of the tunnel.
As opposed to the collapsed sections we just got through.
Yeah, they should have timbered up there, where there's all the collapse. But yeah, there's a shot looking down. Okay, here's some valves, a bunch of valves here on these rusted pipes here in the incline. And then over here, this is the fifth vent that we've seen coming down the tunnel. These vents are for the parallel tunnel that's directly beyond that bulkhead that is pretty wet and damp and full of water. And they had these vents with pipes coming out of these metal bulkheads right there, zooming in on it. They must have had to vent that tunnel for some reason. Maybe because of moisture content or water or fumes, we don't know. Okay, we're about almost approximately 2,000 feet down this inclined shaft, and there's some water here percolating out of the wall. Look at that, right there.
I hate wet mines.
Yeah, we hate wet mines. Somebody put a cup right there to try to catch it. A cup. And that's making flowstone down there, all that water. You can see the white flowstone right there on the tunnel wall. So here's another massive junction of pipes here from the other side here, looking at it from the right side. And then over here, that spring that's right above us in the tunnel is draining. You can see it running down here at my feet. And it's all flowing over here, making a pool right here. That's water. Yeah, right over there, we think is in the distance there. I'm zooming in on it. That's a homemade raft. There's like barrels.
Pontoon boat.
Like a pontoon boat. There's barrels on all four sides of that platform right there. That might have been used by the miners, so when they had to work on those pipes, they needed something to stand on. That's definitely a raft. Okay, we're continuing down here, another timbered section, and the water from the spring is still flowing in front of us, you can hear it. And a little collapse right here on the right. And we're still going down this, we're about 2,500 feet down, and we're still going. This is a massive incline shaft. Okay, we reached pretty much the bottom of this inclined shaft. You can barely see the daylight up there. That little pinpoint of light right in the center of the frame, that's the portal. And we're down several thousand feet. And you can see there's a sign that says exit. We know that. And then over here is where the parallel incline shaft comes down and meets this one. And that's right over here. Okay, this is the, there's a sign in here that says refuge chamber. So they might have used this when they were blasting, and they would come in here and seal these two doors, the one down there, and then the one behind me. And there's a table in here, probably like a break room. Probably also served as a break room. And then over here is where it says refuge chamber on this door right here. So here at the bottom of the incline, we're at a sump area, which is where the water would collect, because you got these flexible hoses here that might have been used to pump out the water, siphon it out. And over here is the actual sump. There's a lot of water there. That's just full of water, deep water. And then over here is, don't know if this was used for draining or what, but here's a pipe that goes way down. So we'll drop a rock in here, see how far down it goes. Pretty far. So we're going to take this junction here. Tunnel continues straight ahead, looks pretty far. And then there's some barrels up here on the left. It says number one shop here above the barrel. So then this might have been a workshop right here. Oh yeah, that's what it was. It's a workshop. There's the sign, number one shop. And then here's where they had tools stored and stuff like that to operate the mine, probably, and repair equipment. We'll take a look in here. Wow. So here's some spare fittings and springs and nuts and bolts and washers and screws and pipes and chain. A little bit of everything. Yeah, right there is a rock drill bit. This stuff here in storage, a couple of them, it looks like. Here's some cubbies for different parts. You can see they wrote on there pipe fittings, pipe nipples, 2-inch hose, clamps, I guess, C clamps, jack leg bits. That says valves, feed chain. That's where they kept all the spare parts. Nuts and washers right there. Yeah, so this is some kind of a drill bit we found here in the workshop.
The rock drill bit that they'd go with the hammer drill and water. They'd be pounding into the rock, spinning and breaking up the rock as they go.
That end right there, that these end, nubs.
And they inject the water in there through it to flush it out.
Yep.
Drill, and it cools it. And they wear down fairly quickly, I guess, when you're drilling a lot. But
yeah, it's pretty heavy, actually, for its size.
Yeah, that's hardened steel. That's the stuff that tool steel, not like.
Here's more cubbies for smaller parts. Different sizes of nuts and bolts and caps, seals, piston seals, all kinds of stuff. So here's the workshop, and there's tunnels branching off everywhere. That's a dead end, but there's a tunnel there to the right, and then a tunnel straight ahead. Looks like a branch to the left and right down there. So here's the back side of the break room, and there's a porta potty here, right there. it probably sat right there in that wooden seat they put the porta potty in, which is right there. And there's an air filter. These boxes are full of air filters. That's a big air filter. Okay, we're just continuing down this drift tunnel. It's just endless, hundreds and hundreds of feet. It looks like we're coming to an intersection right up here. Tunnel going off to the left. So this pipe here has a fitting at the end there that looks like it might have been used for water, maybe to keep the dust down inside the mine, and this goes way up. You're looking straight up vertically. That probably goes to the surface. That just goes forever. And we're down here in these tunnels right here. And here's looking back at that, what we think is a water hose maybe coming down from the surface. And we're gonna go this way. Okay, here's a junction, big junction. Tunnel goes straight and then this is an incline. This is massive. This is 9,838 with an arrow. Must be a stope up here, Paul said. Let's go check it out. So we just came up this little incline shaft and a bunch of signs here. Danger, keep out, restricted area. We think it's restricted and dangerous because of there's a hole here and it's very wet. There's that hole. The whole floor might be undercut with a stope. And that's just a dead end up there.
We got water dripping on us here too.
Yeah, a lot of water here. Flowstone there.
All over, yeah.
Coming down different colors. Yeah, there's a hole there. I don't want to fall down in there.
This is
approaching another junction, some backfill. A lot of sparkles in the wall. I don't know if you can pick that up on the video or not. You can sort of see all the sparkles there as I move the camera around. So we're approaching one of the first stopes, and I can tell by the sound of my voice that we're entering a big chamber. You can see it here in front of us.
Should I go in front of you for perspective?
That's all right.
Down arrow.
There's the top of it, and then don't want to get too close to the edge, but that's looking down over the edge.
Oh, yeah.
Looks like down there.
Yeah, it looks like there's one up here too.
A tunnel or something.
Yeah, I don't think it's, it might be, but I don't think they are. That is just unbelievable.
Okay, we're approaching a four-way junction here in the mine. Massive.
Three-way, I'm sorry.
Three-way junction. Tunnel goes straight, and then there, and then here. So we're taking the middle tunnel here from this three-way intersection and continue straight ahead here. So that borehole right there, looks like there's a copper stalactite. You can see that green growth coming out. And it comes down and dangles right there. And then down here on the floor, it's dripping right there. See that blue-green copper? That's where it's dripping, I guess. Okay, you can see the water dripping here. It's making all these growths, whatever those are, crystals, I don't know, mineral deposits. They're pure white. You can see them all over the place. Okay, here in the tunnel ceiling are some growths you can see coming down there. There's water percolating out of the rocks and making those really kind of spectacular mineral growths. I zoomed in on them there. And here's zooming out. And the tunnel continues that way. You can see Paul up there. A lot of different colors here. That's like an orangish brown. Looks kind of yellow in my video, but and then some dark gray up there in the overhead. And you can see all the growths here on the floor. Pretty amazing colors. Okay, we just came from that way, and we're here at an intersection. There's a tunnel going that way. Paul just went up there to scope it out, and then the tunnel continues that way. There's some collapse there. It looks like it might keep going beyond that collapse. Let me zoom in on that collapse. You can sort of see behind it there that the tunnel might continue onward. But we're pretty far in. Pretty far down, pretty far deep, so we might turn around here and start our long climb out of here.